this morning for waking us up to behold the beauty of another day. We thank you for your mercies that endure it forever. To you be all the glory, to you be all the honor. Thank you for bringing us out of our bed today. Thank you for giving us a new day. Thank you for this platform, the glorious morning shower, and thank you for this media station that you have given to us, the Refs TV. To you be all the glory. Thank you for all our partners. Thank you for every man, every woman there that you have used to be of a blessing to us. We pray today that as we share the word with your people, let the truth about your word be real to every man, every woman that will hear me speak this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to another day with God on glorious morning shower. This is the day the Lord has made, and it is your own day. And as we go into the word of God this morning, I pray that the truth of this word make your way prosperous in Jesus' name. The word for your shower today is, allow God do it. You can't help God. Allow God do it. You can't help God. Most time when word of prophecy comes to God's people, God is declaring over us since the beginning of this month about blessings. There is this tendency that you have what it takes to get some of these things done. And in an attempt to fix it your own way, you miss it. It is a kind of temptation that most people fall into. When God is releasing blessings upon you, when God's servants prophesy over you, don't think that that blessing is going to come from this quarter, is going to come from that quarter, could it be this? And when those things are not coming the way you expected, you feel like, okay, heaven help those who help themselves. So you want to hasten it to come. You can only hasten the blessings of God by prayer. Many people miss the blessing because they have miscalculated. And in the process of trying to help yourself, you must surely miscalculate. Now, we remember the story of Uzzah in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 7. The Bible says, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against Uzzah, and God smote him there for his error, and there he died by the ark. Now, when you compare that scriptures with the case of Obed-Edom, the same ark that destroyed Uzzah blessed a man that was on his own. He didn't do anything. The ark of the covenant was brought to Obed-Edom in his house. He was just resting. This was the same ark that killed in the book of Samuel. Now, when you come to the book of Chronicles, he is now blessing Obed-Edom. One was a blessing to a man, the same was a destruction to another man, just because he attempts to help. You cannot help God. God does not need your help. We are the one that need the help of God. So this idea of man becoming God to himself, it is an error, and it's circulating so much in the body of Christ. God blesses. He doesn't bless because of the volume of prayer you pray. When people boast how many hours they spend in the presence of God. It is good to make you become more spiritual, to make you know more about God, to make you relate with God. But that does not have any way to bribe God. You cannot help God. We are the one that need the help of God. God does not need the help of a man. He is God by himself. So on today, glorious morning shower, in the month of showers of blessing, God want me to remind you that the blessings of God come by the dictate of God, not by the help of any man. You cannot help God. And that is why the book of Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In the process of trusting God for a release of shower, a blessing, a deliverance, an intervention, he said, do not depend on your own understanding. He said, lean not. Don't rely on your own understanding, because your understanding is at the frequency of carnality. It's carnal. So you cannot connect carnality to divinity. They are separate. They are not comparable. They cannot be connected. So I charge you today that you only solemnly depend on God. God is a spirit. He said, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in truth and in spirit. So, combining the flesh with the spirit has been the problem of man from time immemorial. And God wants to use this platform to help you correct that.